Juanita.
Yes.
I have a note here from Dorothy Torito about, said, speaking about taking notes for the library on the occasion of the wedding and the reception for the presidential library. Mm-hmm. Now, she and I talked earlier about suggesting that she might come up on the morning of Lucy's wedding day and sit and take notes in the upper hall about people coming and going and getting dressed and whatnot. Now, on the, as far as the wedding itself and the reception, we will have the voluminous stories of a pretty sizable fresco, or all 4,000 of them fighting to get in, but I think there will be 13 or 14 or something like that in there. At least they will be there at the church, and then they will be there for the limited time at the reception. Could I ask you to keep your eyes open at the wedding and at the reception for any things that you think might be worth remembering for the library, and then maybe quickly thereafter go and write them down, just sort of be a sponge and soak them up?
Yes, I'll be glad to, Miss Johnson. And there's one thing that I've told Dorothy that I think is probably the most needed and would be the most significant thing in to scholars of the future who would be interested in this particular event, and that is if the Monsignor could give us at least, allow us at least to make the pictures of his handwritten notes in his preparation for the nuptial mass, because this is his remarks throughout the mass itself is being sculptured to fit.
Mm-hmm.
Now, to me, and Liz and Beth have both worked and worked and worked and worked with him, and I'm confident that he has many, many handwritten notes, and that these will be typed and that sort of thing for their use. But to me, his notes of, if he has not written notes for record of his conversations with these two ladies, I would be surprised, because these people are trained into good records making. But at least I think that he would be able to dictate it from memory if he has not done that. But the preparation of this particular nuptial mass, since nuptial masses can be tailor-made to fit the occasion, and this one surely is being, to me that is the most significant thing that we want to go after. And Dorothy would have to have some help in getting it.
You mean somebody would have to approach him?
I think that if you told Liz and Bess that we had had some conversation about this, and then give them your feeling, if you feel that this is important and would enhance this package of papers, then I would hope that you would ask them to speak to him about that. And I surely will be. My eyes, I expect, are going to grow about 50 times. I'm not sure that I will.
Of course, I will be remembering everything that I can, but as I think of the people who are oriented in this direction, you seem to me to be the most definitely oriented one and the most interested one, and you'd know what would be, what at least you have feelings about the library and what it should contain. So I just thought if you don't mind, you'd be the ideal one to do that.
Well, I'll be glad to do everything I can. I'm not at all certain that I can be an unbiased observer here, because this young lady has been an object of my prejudiced affection.
Oh, thank you. Hey, you sure did look great last night.
Well, thank you,
ma'am. Stunning outfit.
Thank you.
All right. And then I'm going to ask Dorothy if she would like to. She suggested that she come up and sit in the upper hall and second floor and third floor on that morning and take notes about the coming and going and watch the dressings and so forth.
If that would not I just think this would be wonderful, and she can do it, as you know, very unobtrusively. And I think that it would be an awfully nice thing to do.
All right, and she also mentioned the coming to the rehearsal. That's all right with me. I'll suggest that she do that if she wants to.
Wonderful.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye.